Trump, in speech to farmers today, aims to shore up rural support. President Donald Trump will face a mostly loyal audience with big concerns about his trade and immigration policies when he addresses thousands of farmers and ranchers at the American Farm Bureau convention on Monday. Trump remains popular in rural America, where his deregulatory offensive and tax cuts have won strong support. But many farmers attending the Federation's annual convention say they'll be looking for more specific commitments. They want assurances he won't withdraw from the North American Free Trade Agreement, or adopt immigration policies that make it harder to hire workers to harvest their crops. His proposed cuts to the popular crop insurance program and to the Agriculture Department budget have also alarmed many. The president has always been a proponent of rural America, but we need more than lip service, said Doyle Lentz, a row crop farmer from North Dakota whose top concern is international trade. An October poll of 15,000 people living in small towns revealed that his approval rating had slipped to 47%. Despite such misgivings, the welcome by members of the Farm Bureau, the largest U.S. farmer organization, is expected to be warm. Trump is the first sitting president to address the group in more than a quarter of a century. Support for the president is still there, said Scott Vanderwall, vice president of the Farm Bureau who grows corn and soybeans and raises cattle in South Dakota, citing regulatory rollback and the tax overhaul. But people want assurances about international trade. His support in the Farm Belt would erode if we end up pulling out of NAFTA. Trump's decision to pull out of the Trans-Pacific Partnership trade deal in his first few days in office was disappointing, Vanderwall said. But losing market share in Canada and Mexico, which together account for nearly one-third of U.S. agricultural exports, would be catastrophic to farmers, particularly after four consecutive years of low profits due to depressed commodity prices, he said. While NAFTA hasn't benefited all sectors of U.S. agriculture, including southeastern produce growers struggling to compete against cheaper Mexican imports, the grain and meat industries have profited from an exponential growth in exports. Farmers and ranchers looking for Trump to promise not to withdraw from NAFTA will likely be disappointed, however. A senior White House official said that while Trump will reiterate his desire for trade deals he considers fairer to the U.S., the president will focus on other issues. He is not expected to talk much about his immigration agenda either, even as farmers call on Congress to revamp a temporary agricultural guest worker program that critics say is cumbersome and inefficient. Instead, Trump is expected to tout his deregulatory efforts and endorse recommendations to Wire Rural America expected to be released Monday by his task force on challenges facing people living in remote parts of the country. The key finding of the panel, chaired by Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue, is that rural towns need to be connected to high-speed broadband to promote economic growth. About 39% of Americans in remote areas don't have access to quality broadband, according to the FCC, primarily because the cost of servicing these areas doesn't deliver the return on investment that providers like Verizon look for. However, much of the task force's recommendations reflect work the government is already doing. That includes easing federal permitting in remote areas and connecting rural service providers to dark fiber that has already been deployed, according to Grace Koh, Special Assistant for Technology, Telecommunications, and Cybersecurity at the White House National Economic Council. A senior White House official said the administration has not yet set specific goals, such as connecting a specific number of people to broadband within a set time frame, or estimated costs, but aims to do that down the road. The president is also expected to emphasize the ways in which specific deregulatory policies are helping farmers. This is an audience that has warmly welcomed the deregulatory agenda pushed by the president, said Ray Starling, Special Assistant to the President for Agriculture, Agricultural Trade, and Food Assistance on the National Economic Council, during a briefing with reporters on Friday. I would expect acknowledgement of that, from the American Farm Bureau audience, when the president says what they want to hear, and then certainly, the president acknowledging that he has heard what they want. Trump in March drew raves from many farm groups, for instance, when he signed an executive order instructing the EPA and Army Corps of Engineers to review the Obama administration's Waters of the U.S. rule, and either revise or rescind it. The rule, which would have expanded which waters fell under federal oversight, was despised by the Farm Bureau. Other deregulatory actions, however, have left some farmers feeling like the administration has turned its back on the little guy. Purdue withdrew Obama-era rules aimed at balancing the power between meatpacking companies and the poultry and hog farmers they contract with, contending the changes would result in frivolous litigation. Starling said the president on Monday also plans to highlight the White House's efforts to combat the opioid crisis ravaging rural towns, including declaring the epidemic a national health emergency. To date, the White House hasn't pressed Congress to devote more spending on the effort, however, but instead to leverage current resources. A recent survey commissioned by the Farm Bureau and the National Farmers Union, a more left-leaning organization, found that 74% of farmers and ranchers reported they have been directly impacted by opioid abuse. Also on farmers' minds this year is negotiation and passage of the next farm bill, sweeping legislation that covers programs like crop insurance, commodity subsidies, the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program formerly known as Food Stamps, conservation and rural development. The law expires at the end of September, and Starling said the president is likely to urge Congress to reauthorize it on time. The White House's first budget proposed $29 billion in cuts over a decade to crop insurance, drawing rebukes from the powerful chairman of the House and Senate Agriculture Committees and many agricultural groups that regard the program as farmers' most important safety net. Trump could touch on these topics on Monday, a senior White House official said. But following a year in which Trump didn't spend much time talking about farmers, some are in need of convincing that the president cares about their long-term viability. Lentz, the North Dakota farmer, said that while tax cuts may work in favor of producers, personally he doesn't expect much benefit. And if the law adds $1.5 trillion to the debt over a decade, he thinks that money could have been better spent on the country's aging infrastructure. Lentz said he is holding out for more substantive policies on trade, infrastructure, and agriculture. All the good intentions in the world won't pay my bills at the end of the year, he said.